Hello, my friends. Welcome to Trading with KS. So today is 11th of October, the another trading week. Aren't now a better time to play, right? We have to know that at least we have a, if want to really play, right, at least we have to have a strong sector, right? And if strong sector combined with strong KLCI, aren't this a better time to play? Then we simply close our eyes, jump in and play when the market is really bad. When a 70% stock is going down, 30% stock only going up. Okay, we want to jump into such a big what we call it imbalance in the market, right? So now at least we are having every day more stock going up than more stock going down, right? This is at least a better place. And not only that, we want to go in at a better time, which the KLCI is bullish. We also want to get in, okay, aligned with a strong sector. Means our sector is strong, right? So the sector is strong. Combined with KLCI is strong, right? So this is the right time, right? Oh, you see all the most of the stock we discussed, right? Most of them is all up, right? Because we have to find the right time, right time, okay? Right time, right sector. Okay, right time, right sector. Okay, if you invest on the wrong time, wrong sector, then you have to maybe double check. Rethink your strategy. Okay, we are not saying that our strategy is the best in the world. Okay, nobody has any better strategy. Okay, but our strategy, what I say is our strategy works only. Okay, best or not best is up to you to decide. Okay. So KLCI continue up, but got some pressure over here. 1575, very highlighted this. Okay, am I going into the introduction first before we chat more?
Disclaimer, be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including, without limitation, to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs.
You see, right now market is opening. Air travel is starting. Genting auto start to operate. Toto start to operate. And more spending in the market. Airlines starting can fly. COVID also dropped until I think today I was thinking 6,000, right? I think. So now everything is positive, right? Everything is positive, right? So this is okay, at least, right? This is what we can put it is, at least you can see this is a more, right? More not so tense time to invest, right? During all the drop, it's very tension, right? You look at the market, it's very tension. Everything is very tension. Every day bad news, politics, fight. He don't agree, he want to be minister, he want to be every day this right now. You see all quiet, right? Of course still got some lah, but you see all the things you are feeling, the sentiment is getting better, right? And the stock market also just showing you that it's doing better, right? And then we go to the global first, we see the global before we talk the local one. Remember, we have to see the big picture first, then we look at the macro picture, which is KLCI. Okay, we want the global, the global macro, then we go to the micro, to the stock. Okay, so KLCI in the evening drop a little bit because you know Monday, right, a lot of retailer go in at the evening, they'll take profit, right? So drop 6.9. so tomorrow is most important. Tomorrow's Tuesday, okay, as I said, Tuesday most likely the institution will start to shoot. Okay, today also they shoot, but tomorrow will be more. Okay, tomorrow their influence will be more. So tomorrow is the real direction, okay, where it want to go in the short term. Okay, but today really quite bullish. So today the three brother rebound. Who is the three brother? Serba, SCIB, K Power, right? Later we want to see whether it's a trap or not a trap. Don't simply just jump in. Okay, KLCI 4.0.4% up, 6.9 up, not bad. Singapore up 0.02, Hong Kong up 1.9. So Hong Kong keep on rebounding, Okay, South Korea drop 0.1, Japan up 1.6, Thailand drop 0.3, Philippines up 3.1, quite a lot, China up a bit, FTSE 0.73, SSE China drop 0.013, SXSE China drop 0.32, not very strong, China. Australia drop 0.27, Indonesia drop 0.34, New Zealand drop 0.5, Taiwan up drop 0.44. And Nifty India up 0.32. So not very strong today open, not very strong. Only Malaysia now economy opening up. Market is, you got the push lah, you got the good sentiment. So UK drop up 0.18, a little bit. DAX drop, German drop 0.06, so not very strong. US Dow Jones drop 0.025. US today is holiday, nothing much lah, will not be a lot lah. US S&P dropped 0.19, Nasdaq dropped 0.5, so today holidays sometime like that. So crude palm oil 4965, fantastic. Okay, if the palm oil, our palm oil stock means not the palm oil company with this price cannot make money, I don't know when they can make money. Okay, Brent oil 84, fantastic. Crude oil 81, fantastic. Okay, there is a reason, there is a news why this oil going up so fast. Later we can discuss. Gold just holding 1752 and silver also holding. Okay, so the big winner is the commodity. Okay, commodity is the big winner. So let's check out KLCI first. Okay, so KLCI today continue go up. As I said, you want to shoot between, okay, after go through 1555 only shoot, right? At least we got a few days to play. Okay, now there is some danger over here. 1575, we want to know. Okay, and yes, I want to thank you, Raymond. Raymond, he comment quite a lot. Raymond, he highlighted there is a channel here. He say he saw a channel here, so whether us want to be careful, yes, there is a channel here. We have to be careful. Okay, but this is still some time to go. This channel actually is aligned with a 1600, like somewhere around here. There is still a dark cloud, a dark cloud at our head here between this channel and 1006. Okay, so this is the stronger resistance. This is not so strong, but there is a resistance over here, but not so strong. Okay, but why you already see, right? I really draw here 1575. You see what happened today? The price tried to go through 1575, right? But cannot, right? So there is a resistance here. Okay, there is a resistance here at 1575, right? The next one will be 1600. Okay, this one also aligned, almost aligned with this trend line, okay, this channel downtrend, so there is a dark cloud over here, so we are not out of the woods. Okay, once we pass through here only, we are out of the woods. Okay, we are bull market now. We are not bull market, just uptrend only. We are not bull market, short-term uptrend. Okay, so as long as the price stay above 1555, should be okay. If it push down, cannot stay above 1555, then KO already. Okay, so hopefully tomorrow, okay, the institution come in. If can push through 1575, then it should have another, okay, run towards 1006, around this trend line, and 1006 around this area. This trend line will be around, let me see, around 1590 to 1006. Okay, so this area will be another dark cloud, okay, another resistance. But at least this is slowly going up rather than investing here. Even though it might have a correction, it might go up a bit, then come down a bit, okay, go up a bit, try to break out. This playing here is anytime better than playing here, and anytime better than playing here. At least this is a upwards momentum we are playing. Then you combine with your playing at the right sector, the strong sector, not playing at the weak sector, then you still got a lot of chance. Okay. So let's look at KLCI sentiment 65. Very good. You see gainers, right? These few days, gainers is always higher than losers. Okay, so if you want to play a pool, right? As I said, right, you want to go into a table. When you go to Genting, you want to go into a table to play. You see one table, everyone lose money. One, okay, nine every game, 9% people lose money. One only earn money. Every time the bankers sapu. Okay, you want to sit, play in this table or see the next table. Okay, every day, every time. Okay, 7 win. Okay, 3 lose. Okay, the banker not lucky. Okay, so you want to go that table or you want to support this support table? Every game nine lose or all lose or 9 lose. Okay, you want to go in this table or you want to go in the table? So you know lah. So similar lah. So your probability ma. We have to put ourselves in a higher probability. You see now the market is higher probability. So we see tomorrow. If tomorrow, right, the institution, okay, bullish, they push it up again, then it will go some more very fast. But we have to wait tomorrow. Let's see, today volume. Wow, look at that, 6.9, man. You haven't seen this big volume for a long, long time. So market is very, very bullish, very strong, you know, pushing up 6.9 is very strong. Okay. So as I said, right, you want to fire, shoot, also find the right time to shoot. Okay. Remember here, I said, this one, right, this correction area, this small rebound is time for you to collect back all your bullet, right? Okay, once you already collect back your bullet, okay, wait for a chance, boom, okay, show you the chance already, come already, okay, plantation boom, logistic boom, energy boom, so it's time to fire, okay, so remember, have a strategy, Okay, so wow, very big. Wow, this is big volume, man. Long time never see this type of big volume. Every day 4 point something, 3.9, 4 point something, now 6.9. Okay, so market is very happy. Investors are very strong, their sentiment very strong. They are there to put the money in, right? Okay. Consumer 0.24 up, industry 0.63 up, construction 1.42 up. Construction starting to rebound. So construction, right? We need to start to see already. Start to monitor the construction. I think construction should be coming. Last week when we see the big picture, construction is okay. I said construction is not bad, right? But not very strong, still okay. So I said, right, if construction continue to boom one two more days, it will go through the resistance. Okay, means it will start to go up. Okay, technology up 0.25. Okay, the finance up a bit, today 0.9. Property also up, okay, 1.2, not bad. So this one normally construction up, property up lah, they are almost same industry lah. Plantation also still holding 1.13. Plantation don't expect to go up a lot lah, because plantation already one big push already. Big push. Energy 6.4. Wow, look at that. So healthcare 0.82. Telecommunication 0.36. This was like last time, right? Remember when the gloves start to surge, the gloves push the whole, you know, KLCI, when the gloves start to push last year, right? This year or last year? The big V-shaped recovery here. Yeah, 2020, right? Okay, when the gloves start to push the market up, right? Start to around April, March, April, right? 2020. So when the gloves start to push the market up, right? So this is like quite a similar thing, but not exactly. Because this one, the oil, very volatile, not like glove. Glove get tahan long time, because the COVID increasing. This one, once oversupply, finish. Okay, once oversupply, one new say market oversupply, US, US the storage of the crude oil is growing very, very big. Okay, so you can actually monitor this, looking at the US crude oil, whether it's shrinking or it's growing. If it's growing, then the price will drop. If the US crude oil is shrinking, the inventory, right, there's a report that you can see US crude oil inventory. If it's shrinking, then it will be good. Okay, so healthcare, don't play lah. Telecommunication 0.36 up, transportation 0.4 is still okay, utility 0.09 drop. Okay, so today I could post a lot of things. Now all the Q&A, right, you send me all the question. Okay, if I want to draw a chart to reply you, I will draw it here, put on the Facebook and link to my I will drop it in coffee.com. okay, if you want to buy me coffee now, you can buy me coffee already. ko-fi.com/tradingwithks. Here, this one. Okay, ko-fi.com trading with KS. So here you can buy me a coffee. Okay, it's up to you. Okay, if you think, okay, if you value my contribution, you think, okay, I want to buy KS a coffee, then you just punch in the number you want. Okay, and there's no compulsory. Okay, if you just up to you. So everything I will post there, but I will link or I will relink back to Facebook lah. So you don't need to monitor so many site lah, so many site. But if you want to monitor there also okay lah, because I also want some of you to join there. Okay, some of you, a lot of you also follow me there. It's good also because I want the website also active lah. I don't want coffee not active. Everybody is still here. Then the coffee.com my site over there not active . Then coffee say, oh, this one not active. Until next time, close my account or something. You follow me there also no problem. Okay. So I will most of the time I will relink back to here lah. But sometimes I forget lah. So if I forget, pardon me . Okay. So Forex, remember Forex, want to check out. You guys are interested in Forex, check out. I also got daily Forex video. Forex indexes, US indexes, US DAX, US indexes, DAX, and SPI Australia, and also cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, all those . So morning already quite strong, but morning up a bit more lah, 9.25 and sentiment 62 stronger lah. Morning up is 631, down is 381 . So evening is stock gainer is 737 and losers is 401 still much better lah. So it's a better market. So morning oil really very strong. I highlighted a stronger one construction, plantation, energy very strong. I highlight blue okay. And transportation is still okay. These are the stronger one Make sure right sector lah. So Aeon start to rebound, later we take a look. Asia also hit target already now. Look like want to come down. Later we take a look. Silver three brothers today show sign of rebound. Is it a threat? We take a look. So oil continue to kaboom. Not kaboom. Continue to boom Armada also you continue to fly up. Heng Yuan also follow already start to fly. So all the answer Q&A I put it here Freight I got answer I also put here. Okay, you ask me. I also put here, then I also put on the post lah. Insights also you ask me, also I put here. Also you guys check out lah this one lah. I will not elaborate on this lah. These are the basically some of our friend, some of our family members here at Trading KS ask the question. So if I think I need a chart to explain, then I will post a chart here. Or else I just reply you direct lah. Okay, so MIEG today also boom Okay, so oil boom, MIEG also boom. Also okay, Sealy, I got talk about Sealy lah. I got draw the chart or Insights also, I got draw freight also, so you can check out all these Okay, let's check out the bucket first before we go into the chart So Unisem Q3 sales are likely to be flat so they're not expecting this year Unisem should be to go profit to be very high Okay, due to the closure of their factory, all those things. So, but they do give a target this one we're going to see 5.25 okay, so we want to follow. They say next year only, okay, most likely it will start to grow again next year. So Unisem 5.25, we see, okay. I mean their revenue only last year, next year will start to grow the news is mentioned So Unisem we take a quick look. So Unisem right in the channel okay, Unisem right 5005. Okay, now it's flat lah because of the report saying that it will not have a very the this one November 2nd coming, the next report also will not be very good lah, they expect lah. Okay, so most likely when the thing when Unisem want to start to go up right, it need to go through 4.3 first. Okay, once it go through 4.3 means it got some momentum, you can pick. Okay, maybe go in a little bit. Then if it goes in 4.625, okay, I think this one will show the real power that it will continue go up. Okay, so mark your software here. Okay, you can add but 4.3 only put little bit this one is still dangerous because it's still sideways. Only when it clear this one, clear 4.6, I think then it will be very strong. Also pick one time here, add one time here. Okay, if it goes through okay, maybe, okay, for me, maybe put one alarm here, so when it goes through, okay, I want to take a look. Unisem cross up. So when it cross up, I'll let you know. If I manage to catch it, as I said, I don't I don't on I don't look at the this computer all the time. So when it pop up on my handphone, also if I'm in a shopping mall, now cannot go shopping mall. If I'm in a coffee shop, you buy me coffee, right? So I'm in the coffee shop. Then if I see I don't have the analysis tool, sometimes I bring my laptop out so I can post. If I don't bring, so I don't have tools, then I cannot post. Okay, I already put my alarm here. So when it goes through, then I will know. When it goes through, I will know. Or maybe I put it here first. The first level here. Once you go through 4.3, then I will know. So CPU future to trend lower on take profit. So they are taking that like yesterday. It really spiked up a lot. So this week, a lot of take profit. That's why I said, after a big push, after a very big push, sometimes it will go down a bit. These are all the people take profit. So after a while, then only it will go up again. I have to wait a while. After a big spike. So Busan stay bullish as border reopen. Asia stock also jump. So Asia, we talk about Asia, right? Asia already take profit already. Now we want to see whether it can still go or not. Okay, it can still go or not. Take a look. Okay. Asia, as long as it can hold above 1.255, I think it still can go. Okay, my long target is here, 1.6. Remember, I got long target is here. Okay, so Asia, you want to play, it's like this, okay? It's my long, you see, I already put one clock here. This is a long time target, okay? So, if it can go through above 1.255 and stay above 1.255, then I think it can go. Okay, if tomorrow cannot, if next 2 days it jumped back down, it came back down 1.25, below 1.255 in the next few days, means maybe it will correct one time first before it will go up again. It will rest for a while first. Means this run, this push already finished. Not finished, already want to take a breather, okay? So you want to take profit here, so it's okay. It's okay. Wait for, if I want to take profit here, okay, you see tomorrow, the next 2 days, right, it cannot stand above 1.255, it dropped back down. Okay, red candle coming back below here. Okay, already 1 day, 2 days also stay below here. Then maybe you take profit first, okay? Wait for it come back, rest for about, it burst again. Okay, the next push, go above 1.255, then maybe you chase again. Because you already got bullet, so you can chase, Well, you already take profit, ma. You didn't take profit, you got no bullet, ma. You got bullet already, then you can chase again. This is how I would play, IOI Corp aim to increase oleo chemical earning by 100 million, okay? So what is oleo chemical? Let me take a quick look. What is oleo chemical? I'm not a chemist. Acid containment compound for production of detergent, soap, all those lubricant, soap, vanish, all those so they want to increase their earning on this so looks good for IOI Corp. So let's see what are their stock doing. Wait, I put IOI Corp. Or Plantation. So IOI Corp slowly, they are also Plantation, so now they are slowing down, just continue to hold after big spike. Now it's slow. This is not very bad, slow down a bit, it's not very bad, still okay. So this is a big news for freight. Okay, freight actually bought 3 US freight forwarder company. They want to venture in the US. Total equity of US 2.2 million. Okay. IOS, IOC, and NSC company. These are the three company. Looks like they want to venture in US. So let's see. This why freight went up so high. One of the reason, freight. So freight now slow down a bit. As I said, freight, that day, if we can stay above 1.0, I never put freight here. Sorry, need to put freight here. Just in case I forgot. Okay, same thing. Hold above 1.025 should be no problem going up to 1.29. If we cannot hold above, maybe you want to take loss, cut loss first. Maybe take profit first because it could come down. Okay, look at 1.025. So LBS unveil a prestige president, but I checked the stock, not moving, this one pass first. SolarWest unveil startup program to spur green tech, fintech innovation. So SolarWest launched SolarWest Innovation Lab. Okay, for the entrepreneurs to develop in Malaysia with a renewable energy and green energy. This is a startup program that can help all these company other company to venture into this renewable energy. Let me double check the news. So it's a funding, for those new startup company that to venture into green tech and fintech. Okay, so this is a 10,000 proof of concept accelerator fund, 100,000. So if you are into this, maybe you can apply for it. So let's check out SolarWest whether it got anything to do with their performance of their stock or not. Okay, SolarWest up, no joke, okay, so this one, this news really really got some oomph, got some kick today. So I think I forgot to put in SolarWest also. Did I put in? Got some kick, okay, either it's this news or something other lah. So SolarWest already went through 1.3375, okay. So this one can pick some, okay. So target will be 1.6, 1.9, okay, 1.6, 1.9. These are the two near term target lah. So already got energy today SolarWest, possible, okay. If tomorrow still can go above, stay above 1.37, I think this one got chance. If tomorrow cannot, then maybe you have to be careful. If tomorrow come back down, okay, below 1.375, then we have to be careful. Okay, if tomorrow also can be is above, then I think it can go. Looks like SolarWest can go. Got chance, SolarWest. So crude oil jump and global energy crunch, US oil seven year high. So they are talking about this one, China, because of the weather, so they cannot mine coal, okay. So if they cannot mine coal, where is it? Let me see the China. So India experience electricity backup because coal shortage, all these things, and China want to ramp up the one production of coal, and you see here also got one news, okay, because of the big heavy rain in China, okay, Shaanxi, rainstorm, so coal mine stop, so all these are coal mine stop, then they have to, okay, as far as I know, I'm not a science technology guy, not technology guy, energy guy, okay. So as far as I know, when there is not enough coal, okay, they will use a petrol, right? Fuel, oil, to generate power, okay? So that is why, okay, this is a this crisis will help the this oil to the oil crude oil pump crude oil brand oil to go up. So Malaysia record now 6,000 COVID. That's why this is the if this are the better time to invest. Not guaranteed you go up, but better time. So this one Malaysia say wooden furniture exports to surpass 13 billion. Last year is 12.8 lah. So this news come out, maybe there are some furniture start to move lah, but furniture I don't like to play lah. I don't like to play lah. That's the only problem lah. I don't like to play furniture lah. But maybe if I tomorrow, day after tomorrow, industry continue to go up, we'll take a look at furniture. Okay, industry today not so strong lah, so we don't talk about industry. Industry actually also quite good today, but not so strong. Okay, because we got more to talk, we want to go for the opportunity first before we want to go for the less powerful one. We want to catch the one with the more momentum one first. Okay, so we want to talk about the three brother Serba. What we want to do with Serba. Okay, Serba, right? We already picked bottom here, remember we already picked bottom. Our stop loss is below here, so as I said, if you already picked bottom, if you don't worry, okay, you don't need to put stop loss also, okay, because you just say pick. If you think, okay, your mindset is Serba will not collapse, okay, if you will not collapse, definitely the stock will go up, okay. So I will buy some first, put it there, okay, in case it go back up, okay. And the second mindset is okay, I try to go in, okay, but I have to be careful, okay, because this one Serba now is still in danger, so I don't want to have too much risk, so I will put a stop loss. So stop loss is here below 0.295, so never drop below stop loss lah. So now do we go in now? If you already pick, I will not go in, okay. If I already picked my bottom right last time, I will not go in, okay. When will I go in? Okay, because I already picked, I already got in already, okay. I will wait for the average up. Okay, once it goes through 0.535, I will add. Then goes through 0.75, I will add. Okay, then I will target what? Target the, if the audit problem, no more problem, right? So before the audit problem, how much Serba is worth? Okay, $1.50. Okay, $1.60 before the big drop. We can see the history, right, in the chart. Remember, you can see opportunity, danger, sentiment, and history. Okay. So this one, once you go through, I know the market, if you got no more audit problem, no more problem, right, their stock is worth $1.50, okay. So I target $1.70, it's very little only, okay. So I would have a 154%, okay, after even I average up at a 5.50. Why you want to go all out here? When we are still not clear out of the woods yet, okay, this boost could be still a trap, could still be a trap. Don't think this is a possible powerful push that this guarantee it will go. Nobody know. This one also we thought it will go. You remember this push is even bigger, right? This push is even bigger. We thought it's gonna go, but it didn't go. So this push is so small, you think it will guarantee it will go? We don't know yet. Okay, if the push is over 5.3, okay. All the bank, all the chartists, all the experts will see, will have the same view as us because we are looking at the chart. This is a possible a goal. Okay, so momentum will come here. Momentum will not come here. It will show one time already. This is not the where the bank, all those will push. Okay, already show you one time. So another push over here doesn't mean the bank, okay, all the big bank, because Serba, all these got investor from KWSP, all those, right? So all the big institution might not push, okay. So if we go through here, all the institution I think will push, okay. This is my mindset, like, this is my thinking. So if you already go in, leave it first, okay. Wait for the break. I will leave it first, wait for the break of 0.53, because we still got so much gap to chase. No need to worry about a little push. If you haven't go in, maybe you can pick some bottom, okay. Just wait and see, and add up here during the going up. And K Power. Okay, K Power, the stop loss is 0.615, right? So it also didn't drop below 6.315, 0.615. Okay, so this one, if you already in, continue to hold. Okay, if you haven't in, you want to pick some bottom, maybe can. But where is the place that you need to add more? I think to add, right? I think better here. I think better go through here. You want to add, go through here. Around this area, 0.83. Once you go to 0.83, maybe you want to add. Okay, it's your second up, second add up. So this one we will target here. The price before the big drop is around 170. So we'll target 170. If the thing really start to go up, so you add a bit. I will add a bit here. Okay, 0.83, and possible I will add a bit here. Here. 0.975, and we'll target up to this one, 1.7. So this one, maybe if it works up right, if it works out fine, we will get around 100% also. But don't think this is over. This is not over yet, because there's no news coming out saying that there are problem. Okay, the Asoba problem has been resolved, all this thing. So this one still can boom on. So you guys be careful. This one still can boom to 20 cent to 10 cent, still can one. You don't think that this one straight away you go to the sky. Because we have no info, no news out saying that their problem has been resolved. SIB today also up a little bit. SIB a bit worse. SIB already stopped below the stop loss. Okay, if you already cut loss, it's never mind. Okay, wait for it, because SIB is not doing that well. Okay, already below the stop loss. So SIB, you want to play, okay, you want to play, you already cut loss, this one have to wait longer. Wait for it to really go up to here, because it's very weak. It's very, very weak, okay. Maybe goes above here, only want to go in, 0.655. Goes above 0.655, only want to start to average up, okay. This one, our target will be around here, before the big drop, before the break drop, our target will be around here. 150. Okay. 150. If it can go up, it can. Once we start to pick, 150 is around 122%. No guarantee, this one. But this one, you have to watch out. Have to watch for it. So this one could still be a trap, so don't go in all in, okay, it could still be a trap. So Aeon start to push a little bit today. We talk about here, right? If it drop below outside this channel, we want to cut loss. So it's sideways a bit now today, push a bit. Well, Monday I'll take profit also, so this one continue to hold, looks still okay, up a bit. Armada, so energy, Armada today fly. Armada today fly, boom, so continue to hold. As I said, this one still can hold. So today already go through 0.505. The next target will 0.54. Once you go to 0.54, you can look for 0.63. So it's very, very strong. Also Heng Yuan, I talk about Heng Yuan. Heng Yuan also push up already. So next target is 5.1. Next target is 5.58. The likely target, the likely one is 5.9. Okay, the likely one, I think it can go to 5.9. But all these have to monitor the oil price first, and the oil index, okay? If the index got any problem, I'll let you know, the oil price on the, and the energy index, sorry, not the oil index, so I will let you know this one. I'll continue to hold this one. My EG, today also big push, my EG, so we want to know what happened, whether this is sustainable or not. Oh, this is very strong. Now got support already, my EG. Okay, my EG after this big push got support already. So the support is here. As long as it don't go below 0.995, it don't drop below 0.995, I think it will continue to go. So the stop loss will be here. 0.885, okay. So this one, I think, let me see, EG. Where's the resistance? Okay, my EG would look for, watch out for this level, 1.135, 1.2. I think my EG slowly, depend on which one, I think slowly it can still continue go up, my EG. After this big push, I think it can slowly, it can go up. Looks like the momentum come already for my EG. The time for my EG come already. Looks like it. Unless it goes back below 0.995, then you have to be very careful. Unless it go back below 0.995, then you have to be very careful. AWC also, I see some momentum today. Let me see. Let's take a quick look. Take a quick look at AWC. Oh, went inside the channel, so this one, as long as it can stay above 0.535, I think it got chance to 0.66 middle channel. 0.66, 0.74, I think can. Top channel, I think a bit difficult, too far. 0.66 and 0.74, I think can. It need to stay above inside this stay firm inside above 0.555, okay, 555. Okay, then we got another one, construction WCE. WCE also got some push. I already put one alarm ready. It need to stay above 0.415, then only it got chance to go higher. Okay, this one I just put an alarm, let you guys know. You need to break out the channel, stay above 0.415, then we can look for because construction start ready today, got some momentum lah. I just highlight two first lah. Okay, 0.45 and 0.495 got chance lah. This one watch lah. Watch out for this one. Did I miss anything? Let me see. Okay, that's it for today. Don't forget one thing Don't forget this Don't forget subscribe, like and share, pump up the like and share it, share my video with all your friends, okay, who play stock market and Malaysia stock market especially. Like my video, pump it up, the like for me. If you're new here, subscribe every day. I got video every day. I got 2 video, one Chinese, one English, 7 to 8 o'clock. I will upload afternoon. Check out my Facebook. Okay, any opportunity, I will post in my Facebook and Twitter. Trading with KS, I think today I forgot post Twitter. Getting old. A lot of people asking me how old am I. A lot of people asking me how old am I. You want to guess how old am I? Give you guys a chance. Put in the comment. See which one of you actually managed to guess how old am I. Remember, okay, now you can buy me coffee. Okay, go to coffee.com, ko-fi.com, trading with KS. You can punch in, your PayPal, or your credit card. Okay, you can buy me a cup, 2 cup, 10 cup, also it's up to you. Okay, half cup also it's up to you. Okay, if you want to support my channel, if you think the channel here is valuable, it's a value to your research. Okay, you can always buy me a coffee. Okay, see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.